Hi, everybody, and welcome back to 2Be Like Christ. You ever heard that story about Jesus driving people out of the temple with a whip and turning over their tables? You ever think that maybe Jesus was a little bit extreme when he did that? In this video, we're going to talk about why Jesus had a right to be as angry as he was. Okay, so in a previous video, we talked about Matthew the tax collector and how tax collectors were notorious for ripping people off. Well, in this video, we're going to talk about some other people who were notorious for ripping people off. And unfortunately, that group of people was the priests. They were a specific people who God had set out to do his work within the temple, and yet they were ripping off their fellow Jews. This is what makes Jesus so angry. And the best way to understand that is to do a little bit of research into just how much money the temple was making and how it was making it. So to understand the temple that Jesus walked into, you have to understand that that wasn't the first temple. Solomon had built a temple, and it was just beautiful and gorgeous, but it was destroyed when the Babylonians came along. The exiles came back to Jerusalem and rebuilt it, but it was nothing like it was originally. But then when Herod the Great came along, he decided that he was going to do a favor to the Jews and also to himself, and he was going to make the temple great again. So he did a big expansion project, and he actually added a lot to the temple that God had never designed originally. And part of what he added was stalls and shops where vendors could set up, kind of like a marketplace, so that they could make the temple really into a money-making machine. And some of that money came back to him. Obviously, this was not the intended purpose. The temple was not originally for profit, and Herod and the priests who were helping him were impeding the worship of the Jews as they were trying to do what was right under the law of Moses. The temple made money in at least three ways. The first one is the temple tax. So this is actually talked about in Exodus chapter 30, and every man had to pay a half shekel, which was about a day's wage back then, once a year. And this was collected throughout all the Roman Empire, and then it was shipped back under armed guard to Jerusalem into the temple. Josephus, in one of his books, Wars, actually writes about Titus, one of the generals of the Romans, speaking to the Jews and telling them that they had made an enormous amount of money collecting this tax. So just how much was that? So I got some really rough numbers here, but it'll give us an idea. So if a half shekel is about a day's wage, let's say you make $10 an hour and you work 8 hours a day. And let's give a rough estimate of about 3 million Jewish men throughout all the empire. If you do the multiplication there, annually, the temple was bringing in approximately $240 million. And of course, the temple had expenses. They had to pay the priests. They had to keep things, you know, up and running. But still, that's a lot of money. So there's nothing necessarily wrong with that. But where we get into difficulties is with the other money-making propositions that Herod had set up. And the Jewish elite were helping him run. The second way the temple made money was through money changers. We would think of this as like exchanging your money when you go to a foreign country. Because you couldn't just use any money in the temple. You had to use a specific kind. And they actually used a currency from the city of Tyre because they weren't allowed to print their own money based on the Roman rules. So if you were coming from anywhere except for Tyre, which was probably most people, you would have to have your money changed at the temple so that you could give your half shekel tax and buy anything that you needed to buy. And so Jesus seems to indicate that these money changers were really extorting money from the people, and they were really ripping them off and making it hard for them to worship. Okay, so let's say you're a Jew and you live 100 miles away from Jerusalem, but every year you come down to Jerusalem for the feast. And so you go to the money changer and you get your money changed and he rips you off. So you have to pay your half shekel tax, but then you also need a sacrifice. So in some way, you've got to come up with an animal to fulfill the sacrifice. Now, you could have brought it from your home, but that was 100 miles away. Who wants to drag a sheep down the road for 100 miles? It could get stolen, it could get injured. And remember, an injured sheep wasn't any good because the sacrifices had to be without blemish. So the priest knew this and Herod knew this. And so he said, oh, you know, I'll sell you an animal at the temple. But they were selling them for very, very high prices. It was also the priests who inspected the animals that were being brought for sacrifice. And so you can see if these people are really that dishonest, you can see them inspecting animals that are pretty healthy at the gate, but they're finding little tiny imperfections and saying, no, you can't use this animal. You better buy one of ours. And so the Sadducees, who were in charge of the running of the temple, were really like triple dipping on these people. They were getting them with the exchange rate for their money, and then they were having to pay the half shekel tax. And then on top of that, they were charging them ridiculous amounts of money to buy animals. Josephus, in another place, actually calls the high priest at that time a great hoarder of money. The position of the high priest was supposed to be filled by an individual who was from the line of Aaron, but that was actually not the case any longer. The high priest was a bought position. So whoever bribed the Romans the most got to be the high priest and got to take part in this lucrative money-making machine. In the book Antiquities, Josephus writes that Crassus, a Roman, came and raided the temple in about 54 AD, and he took all the gold, and that gold was equivalent to 176,000 pounds of gold, roughly, which if you do the math on today's gold rate per ounce, that's about $3.5 billion. The priests, the Sadducees, weren't in this because they wanted to help people improve their faith and be faithful to God. They were in this because they were extremely wealthy because of what was going on in the temple. And keep that in mind. Why do the Sadducees have such a problem with Jesus? It's not because they're worried about the people's souls that Jesus is going to lead them astray. It's because Jesus is saying things like, one day you're not going to sacrifice at the temple anymore. And Paul's coming along preaching and saying, you are the temple of God. You individuals, you Christians are the temple of God. Which means what? That the Sadducees' business, the temple business and money is in danger. There's a threat and they have to stomp out Jesus and Paul if they're going to keep their business going. And so now seeing kind of a bigger picture, when we see Jesus coming into the temple and cleansing it and driving these people out and being so angry and saying that they've made God's house a den of thieves, it makes a little bit more sense. And you can see why God, who wanted his people to be faithful to him, would be so angry at people who made it so hard for his people to be faithful to him. So I hope that's been helpful to you and it gives you a little bit more insight into that Bible passage. If you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, do that and comment down below if you have any more insights that I looked over. Share the video, hit that like button, and I'll see you next time.